Hello, good morning students.
Good morning, sir.
So we have discussed the vowel sounds and today we shall discuss diphthongs. Diphthongs. Yeah. Diphthong, you know, is in fact a Greek word which means two sounds. Okay, which means two sounds. So when a syllable has two sounds within it, we call it a diphthong. Well, I am talking about syllable. So before I come to diphthongs, I would like to tell you about syllable. What is a syllable? If I ask you, what do you think a syllable is? Well, if you don't remember, I must tell you that syllable can be, say, a single letter or group of letters that include a distinct vowel sound. It can be a single letter or a group of letters that include a single vowel sound. For example, you know, if you remember, while you were discussing vowel sounds, I had given you examples of above, okay, and about. Okay, let me write about here then. This is about. Here, this is a single syllable, but this syllable is unstressed, and here you have just one letter, a single letter, and here you have group of letters. So a syllable can have a single letter or a group of letters. But how do you divide it? You divide it according to the vowel sound. According to the vowel sound. Like, I must say that a single syllable has a distinct sound. Here you have au sound, this is a diphthong because two vowels are coming together, and this is shua, as you know, is a vowel sound. Let me take another word for example. Like, for example, say, yeah, ivy. I am taking a small word, okay. IV. Although it's a very small word, here again you have two syllables. How? I has a one distinct vowel sound, and V again has one distinct vowel sound. How do you transcribe? You transcribe IV, IV, I. I, V, I. This is a diphthong and this is a vowel sound. I, V. This is how you transcribe it. You understand what a syllable is?
Yes, sir.
So as far as vowel sounds are concerned, in vowel sounds, you have just a single vowel within a syllable. And as far as diphthongs are concerned, you have two vowel sounds within a single syllable, two vowels. Okay, just don't be confused. Say that you have two vowels. So each syllable has one distinct vowel sound within it, as far as vowel sounds are concerned. But if you talk about diphthongs, in diphthongs you have two vowel sounds. Here you have two. Ow. Is that fine?
Yes,
or say boil, for example. In boil also oi. Oh, and how do you write boil? You write boil like this. Here you have two vowels. This is a vowel. This two is a vowel. The two vowels are coming together. When two vowels come together, you have a diphthong over there. Here you have a diphthong here in the word boil. Or say house, for example. House. How do you write house? This, yeah. You write house like this, and how do you transcribe? You transcribe house this way. So here also you have a diphthong. So diphthong have two distinctive vowel sounds within them. Okay, remember this. Diphthongs have two distinctive vowel sounds within them. For example, the word house or say boy. Okay, so the first diphthong that we discuss is A-E. A-E, you know, I will not like removed it, rub it off. Why? Because you might need the same three-term description even for the diphthongs. So, as you know, A is a vowel sound and E again is a vowel sound. When you join these two vowel sounds, you get a diphthong and you get an altogether different sound. Now, it's not a single sound. Okay, it's a mixture of two sounds. It's a fusion of two sounds and both are distinctive sounds. Okay, they're not the same sounds as you have in, say, prolonged vowels like oo, like cool. Now, you cannot say that this is a diphthong. This is not a diphthong. Why? Because this is a single sound. Oo, there is no change in it. When the sound changes, okay, then only you have a diphthong. Here, see, sound is changing. A-E, A-E, A-E. Notice the position of my lips. A-E, A-E, A-E. The position of lips is changing. Why is it changing? Because there is a glide, there is a movement, there is a change from one position of a sound to another position of a sound. Is it okay? Now, you cannot say that this is a diphthong. This is not. This is a prolonged vowel sound. So, yeah. So, this is A. Where do you have A? You have here. And E you have over there. So, this is a glide from this sound to that sound. If I tell you the three-term description, then how would I tell you? Because you already have this thing with you. Well, this is A. A you have here. So this is a glide. This vowel sound is a glide from front unrounded vowel between half closed and half open to there. Where? Here. To the centralized front unrounded vowel between closed and half closed. Is it okay? So it's a glide from A to E. A, A. Is it fine?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So that's why, you know, I have maintained this. So this is how we are going to learn. So this one is our first diphthong. A, A. See? Your tongue is gliding, you know, like from one position to another. So this one is the first that we are talking or that we are discussing. Let's do the same way as we did with the vowel sounds, initial, median and final sounds. So let us take the initial sounds first. Initial. Yeah. Initial. So initially it occurs in words like just try to know the sound, A, A. So where do you have A, A in the beginning? You have in words like 8, 8, I'm taking a small word here, 8, 1, 2, 3, 5, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, this is what, 8. So how do you write? First you take this diphthong, A, 8, 8, or for example, 80. What do you do here? You just add E sound here, 80. If you write 8 or 80, this is the initial A sound, A sound. Yeah. Next word can be, for example, ace, ace which you have in playing cards. How do you write ace? You write ace like this, A-C-E, and you would transcribe it this way, A, ace, ace. Okay? Or for example, ache, headache, ache, ache, ache. Now, this is, you know, like sound is changing. Ache. How do you write ache? A, ache, ache, ace, 80, 8. This is how. Yes? Can you tell me some words from you? Or for example, yes, aim, for example. Aim. Aim. How would you write? Aim. 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 Yes. One or two words from your side also.
Echo.
Okay. How do you spell it?
E-C-H-O.
E-C-H-O. Okay. Echo. 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 This is echo. This is how it is. Echo. Okay. This is a diphthong. You know, it begins with a diphthong sound and it also ends with a diphthong sound. I've seen people saying it echo, echo. Okay. It's not echo or echo. What it is? What is it? This echo, echo. Or say, for example, able, able, able. How will you write able? Able, able, able. Is it okay? Able. Or say, 18. How will you write 18? Eight. This is eight. Then in 18. 18. Now this is long E. 18. This is our team. 18. It's fine?
Yes, sir.
This is okay?
Yes, sir.
Now can we move on to the next sound, this video?
Yes, sir.
You understood this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is up, you know, the here your sound changes from one vowel sound to another. Aim, aim, echo, able.